On a beautiful night in Atlanta, Georgia, we welcome you to the NBA on TNT, all presented by State Farm. It's the Toronto Raptors taking on the playoff-bound Atlanta Hawks. Atlanta trying to secure the fifth seed and hold off the Chicago Bulls in the Eastern Conference as the regular season ends tomorrow, with the playoffs starting Saturday. Al Horford, Reg, is not going to start for Atlanta. Give me a matchup you're going to watch here early between the Raptors and the Hawks.
Well, what did Larry Drew tell us? Kyle Korver is going to be challenged trying to guard Rudy Gay, especially the way he's able to play in that mid-post game. Kyle Korver, though, on the other end, has to run Rudy Gay off those screens to try to tire him out.
The Raptors are in 10th position in the Eastern Conference, 4.5 games out of the playoffs and back of number 8 seed Milwaukee. But this Toronto team, Reg, is 9 wins better than they were at the same time a season ago. This is clearly an ascending team in the Eastern Conference.
A lot of injuries decimated this team, and it started early on in training camp. Kyle Lowry is the starting point guard for the Raptors. Ankle injury really got off to a slow start. Jose Calderon took his starting position. He regained it. They traded Calderon to the Detroit Pistons, and they're starting to take off now. But you're right, they're a young team. Good young pieces in Rudy Gay, DeMar DeRozan, Terrence Ross off the bench, the rookie from Washington, and Jonas Valančiūnas.
After having lost 3 in a row, and they're number 5, as you mentioned before, in the East. A missed shot by Gay, picked up inside and put in by Valančiūnas out of Lithuania.
And what Valančiūnas does, we talked about the rookie, good soft hands, block shots, excellent offensive rebounder, runs the floor. Really learning this game as a rookie.
This is DeRozan again. That's a 2, and he puts.
But if Rudy Gay and DeRozan are going to coexist and take this team to the next level, and Dwayne Casey told us, both of them have to improve their outside shooting. They both have to become better three-point shooters as Kyle Lowry knocks down the 3. Because if they can stretch the floor, it's going to allow Valančiūnas to be more successful down low. As we saw, 3 threes already by the Hawks in this first quarter. But they're second in assists, almost 25 a game, and 3rd in fast break points. And a lot of that comes down because of Devin Harris and his ability, as we just saw 2 floaters when he got into the lane. He's excellent at coming off that high screen and roll, making things happen. Nice alley-oop there from Lowry to DeRozan. And, you know, you're right for the round.
Kia MVP, Scott Mack Jenkins. Rosen came in front of him. Ivan Johnson inside. Valančiūnas knocks it away and picked up by Lowry. Good rejection right there. He's missed the last couple games with a neck injury. And Rudy Gay popping the 3. Johnson inside with a nice twister.
Run the team.
Pick and roll there. Johnson was taking it inside. Knocked out of bounds. Not a rugged player who has played all over the world. Is Raptors will go to the bench, and Quincy Acey will come in, a rookie out of Baylor.
Tell you what, Valančiūnas is a big,
he is big,
big,
isn't he?
Yeah. Guy. I mean, when you watch these guys on TV, this is our first opportunity to see Toronto Raptors up close.
I haven't seen Toronto in 7 years in person.
No, you're right. You said it right the first time.
In person, Terrence Ross has come in. Here comes Ross the other way, the rookie from Washington.
By 3 at the end of the first quarter. It's time for the Lincoln Ford Coach's Corner. I'm here with Dwayne Casey. Coach, close to 70% shooting throughout that first quarter, and obviously Atlanta plays good defense at times. How are you be able to crack it?
Well, the thing about it is the team that plays defense first is going to win. We're trying to get defense in the game. We've got some stops and we're able to run, but the key is having a defensive focus and locking in. Right now, we're kind of, both teams are kind of feeling each other out.
You're eliminated from the playoffs, yet you won 5 of the last 6. Why are these games meaningful for you?
Well, right now we're trying to build for next year. We're still in the building mode, building process. We had an opportunity to knock on the door a few games ago back, and we were 3.5 out. Right now we're playing for pride, building for next year, trying to develop our young core.
All right, thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Out to Smith, fresh shot clock, 7 to play in the half. Harris outside. That's a Tolliver 3.
Oh my goodness. I mean, that alley-oop was from half court.
That was a nice Lowry pass.
We talked about Valančiūnas having those good hands for a big man. one of those things that are essential for most big guys. Either you have soft hands to be able to catch a 35-40 foot alley-oop, or you don't. I might accept you on that offer.
Yeah, do you want to walk across the street?
I may accept you, Kenny. I may be coming in.
This is Devin Harris. 3-point shot won't
My
go.
My goodness.
Valančiūnas picks up these,
you know, Petro or a role player.
Teague on the baseline.
I love what Larry Drew said about Ivan Johnson. He plays every minute on the floor like it's his last.
Well, if you're actually in Boston, ready to do the game, weren't you, Craig?
Yes, and I talked to both teams today. Doc Rivers lives on Boylan Street, just a couple blocks from where the finish line is.
They do fly a little bit higher than a lot of teams. Petro inside. Jenkins missing at the other end. Lowry taking it the other way. 7 minutes gone in the third. Valančiūnas inside is spinning and fouled as he goes up. The Eastern Conference Rookie of the Month of March, and a bright future for him. The foul will go on Petro, and that is the first on Johan. 8 points and 6 rebounds for this rookie, the two-time Lithuanian Basketball Player of the Year. Jonas Valančiūnas.
I like him.
Junis.
Room to grow. He has room possibly to fall to the eighth spot if they lose that game to the Lakers.
Valančiūnas had an injury too. He had the neck strain. He was questionable. Missed the last couple games of that before coming into tonight. But his last 5 games, Valančiūnas had averaged 14 points and 5 rebounds. As that goes in there from Scott. And tonight, he's got 8 points and 7 boards.
And I believe Dwayne Casey told us that he's going to play for the Lithuanian national team during the summer.
A nice summer of growth.
Continue to play basketball and work into that body. They don't have a first-round draft pick. That came in the that was sent out during the Rudy Gay trade. So Terrence Ross, his growth within. And they've got to get stronger.
Wasn't that a nice move by Valančiūnas?
It surely was.
My goodness.
And that's part of getting stronger.
Yes.
He's got to get stronger down low to take the NBA rigors of a long season.
Houston Lakers. And I will be in front of my set watching both those games.
And how about the Jazz Grizzlies? The Jazz obviously need to win.
Coming back from a sprained left ankle. So he is not quite 100%. Knocked away by Valančiūnas. And out of bounds. 9 seconds on the shot clock.
Third block there. Valančiūnas.
There's a look at Larry Drew, whose son played point guard, you may recall, at UCLA, and before that in North Carolina for Roy Williams. Tolliver hedges over on Lucas. Valančiūnas kicks it outside, and 9 on the clock, and Allen Anderson. Easy. Loose ball foul, Dante Jones.
Paul George. You know, without Danny Granger out with the knee injury, became an all-star, does it at both ends of the floor.
And 4 of the 5 starters for Toronto tonight, double figures, led by the 30th, DeMar DeRozan. 22 for Gay. Valančiūnas inside, up against Tolliver. First on Anthony Tolliver.
For the rookie pack.
Valančiūnas will put that in. 140 to play.
This is a game that will never end, which is good.
Kind of like those Reggie Awards we've been watching all night. That was so bad.
The producer is speaking in your ear, and then you're just copying what he's saying.
I was on my own there. And that is clearly what this Toronto team is. And the 3 by Mac. And now with Rudy Gay, they're going to be 16 and 16 when he plays. And those are the kind of numbers that you can really foster some goodwill and improvement into the offseason.
Yeah, you're Dwayne Casey, and when you do your exit meetings, you talk about those things, you know, building towards the future. And we have a young team, relatively young, and we can keep everyone injury free and get a training camp underneath our belt. Good things can happen.
All right, here's Lucas now in the final seconds. Mac defending, and John Lucas comes up with another deuce. Lucas with 11, 4 of 8. And Tolliver will hold it as this game is in the books. And the Hawks have their very short two-game winning streak stopped. And the Toronto Raptors have now won four consecutive games. Couple old friends, Dwayne Casey and Larry Drew, shaking hands. Toronto winning their sixth game in their last seven. And with the loss, Atlanta goes in back of Chicago to number six in the East.
With a possible first-round matchup of Frank Vogel and Paul George, Neil Hibbert, David West, and the Indiana Pacers.
All right, so Toronto wins it tonight, and they get 30 points from DeRozan and 22 from Gay, 13 from the rookie center, Valančiūnas. Nice looking win for them against the playoff-bound Hawks. Our producer, Ross Schneiderman, we thank him tonight for everything he has done. And our director, Chris Grain. Our associate producer, Scott Cockrell. Special thanks to Stephen Daly and Sean Gerchikoff and Donzel Floyd and Ron Mojica. Kevin Harlan for Reggie Miller and Craig Sager saying so long.
One, two, three, four.